There are many bits in it which surprise and startle me, and I can never quite know which bits are really going to get me, except one thing which always gets me, and I always prepare myself for it, try to resist it, or at least hide myself so that I'm not too shamingly sobbing. And that's the Abamadi. I don't know why it gets me. Even to think about it, though, actually, I can feel the tears starting in my eyes now, and I don't know what it is about it. It's something about what it expresses. That moment of knowing that you have forgotten that someone has said something about what you're going to do, that you will betray me, and you've gone through the whole of this ghastly, disheveled night, and just as was predicted, you've gone and done it. You have done it. And you just beg for some sort of forgiveness. But it's the music in which it's expressed, which that violin. It doesn't matter whether you're an atheist or a Jew, by being an educated member of Western European civilization, it is the most famous story there is. It's in your bloodstream in the way that no other story is. And it happens to be the most intensely dramatic story. You can read it again and again and again, and it never fails as a piece of drama. Now, you see, the crouching clergyman would say, well, the reason why it never fails is because it has an eternal truth. And that truth is religious, and you are yielding to it because you're resisting the religion, the religious belief which is in you. It's not the case at all. It's something that is permanently there, whether you believe it or not, which is the fact that we're here to suffer, and that our profession in this world is to die. Thank you.
sure.